Hello, I'm Benjamin Monmège, and together with Julie Parot, we'll present what we did with Pierre-Alain Régnier about weighted time games and how, in this context, memory can be emulated by stochasticity strategies. First, let me give you a word of context. So our motivation is to use game theory for synthesis. In the classical approach, we check the correctness of the system, we verify it against a given specification. By using game theory, what we want is to model the system as an interaction between two antagonistic agents, the environment and the controller. And the controller represents what we want to achieve. And the code synthesis then is synthesizes automatically a controller that will be correct by construction and which will be a valid model for our system. In this context, there are different classes of games that we want to study depending on the specification that we want to achieve in our system. So a first very simple kind of games are qualitative games where you have a Boolean objectives, either it's true or false, like reachability or repeated reachability. There are also quantitative games where the arena is equipped with some weights. And now in the long run, you want to achieve a particular measure, a particular payoff. And the typical payoffs in this context are mean payoff, discounted payoffs. Now, of course, you can combine both qualitative and quantitative objectives, having in mind that you want to achieve a qualitative objective for sure, and then you want to optimize along certain quantities. An example of such games are shortest path games, where you want to reach a certain target state while minimizing the total payoff along the way. So we will study this kind of games, but in a particular setting where the arenas are not finite because this is timed games where you have real valued clocks. Let me give you an example of such weighted time game. It's a finite arena a priori, so there are a finite number of states that we call locations, L0, L1. And you see that because it's a game, you have a partition of these locations among two players, a minimizer that will be the controller player and a maximizer that will be the environment. It's a weighted time game, so time means that there are real valued clocks. Here there are two clocks, X and Y, that evolve synchronously as the time passes. And you can test the values of such clocks along edges. So you can test the value of clock X, for instance, from transition L0 to transition L1. You can test whether the clock value is between 1 and 2. And moreover, you can reset or not certain clocks. So here you reset the clock X. Here you do not reset any clock. This is a target state, so it's a reachability game. So here it's the target. For instance, if you start in location L1 with both values of clocks, which are real numbers, being 0, then the minimizer player will choose either to take this edge or this one. So for instance, he could choose to take this transition, this edge A, and then he must choose what is the delay that he wants to spend in the location. So here, for instance, he could spend half unit of time. The next configuration will be the location L0 with the value of clock X, which has not been reset, 0.5, and the value of Y that has been reset is 0. And then it's max player that will play for the next turn. And again, either choose A or choose B, and you continue like that until you reach the target, in which case the play stops. And now the payoff that we will consider is the shortest path payoff, which means if you do not reach the target, since we consider the point of view of minimizer that wants to minimize the cost, then you will get plus infinity because it's the worst you can hope for. And if we reach the target, then the payoff will be simply the sum of the weights along the way. There are two kinds of weights. There are weights on edges, and there are weights in locations, which are rates of weight. So the weight of the first move is 0 because of this 0 on the edge. And then you multiply the delay that you spend in a location by the weight of the location. So here, the first transition costs 1 because of this 1 here, times 0.5 because you delay 0.5. And you do like that for all the transitions. And then you make you take the sum of all these weights, and you get the weight of a particular play. Now, the objective of min and max will be minimizer wants to minimize the payoff and maximizer wants to maximize the payoff. And to do so, they have to apply some kind of strategies. So the simplest strategies that have been considered so far are deterministic strategies, where both players choose one particular edge and then one particular delay. So for instance, minimizer should choose between A or B, and then maybe, for instance, he could decide to choose A and then a delay, which is a particular delay T, which is less than one. He could also choose edge B. But what we will be interested in is to study probabilistic strategies, so to use randomization in order to distribute over all the possible choices. So it has been studied in the context of stochastic timed automata. We take a finite distribution on the edges, and then the delay will be somehow an infinite distribution. It could be a continuous distribution over various delays. For instance, you could choose between edge A and B with a Bernoulli distribution of parameter P. And then if you get the edge A, you could choose T, the delay, with a uniform distribution over the whole interval 0, 1. Or you could even play a non-continuous distribution, a Dirac distribution, for instance, and play a particular delay, 1.5. So this is in contrast with this work that is in the footnote, where such Dirac distribution is not allowed. Here, since we want deterministic strategies to be a particular case of probabilistic strategies, we incorporate this capability in the strategies. So you see that there is a whole zoology of strategies, because you have either probabilities or determinism, and also another dimension of this zoology is the kind of memory that players can use. Letting C be the set of configurations, so you have a location and you have the values of all the clocks, then the whole set of strategies is just saying you have the whole play sequence of configurations, and you choose a distribution over the next location, so the edge that you are taking, and a delay. Of course, you could take the restriction to be deterministic, in which case you just consider one possible action, one possible choice in this distribution. Now you could limit the memory and consider finite memory strategies. So for instance, in the deterministic case, it's just a Moore machine. When you are in a given configuration, you can compute a given memory status after finite play, and you have a finite number of states, and then you take a decision. And you could imagine a probabilistic Moore machine where then it's more like a Markov decision process or a Markov chain. Then from finite memory, also you could consider memoryless strategies, where you do not at all consider any kind of memory. So you just play in the arena and you are just considering some particular possible action in each configuration, or you consider, again, a probability distributions on these actions. Now, what we did is to consider in these games where you see in the arena, there is no probabilities, but we incorporate the probabilities in the strategies in order to see what happens in this context. And so we can define in this setting a stochastic value, which means we take the point of view of the minimizer player, and we consider an infimum over all the strategies of min, of a supremum over all the strategies of max, of the expectation that you get for the shortest path payoff in the Markov chain that is constructed from a given configuration by following these two strategies, sigma and tau. And of course, you could consider two particular restrictions, one which is the memoryless value, where both sigma and tau, the strategies of min and max, are restricted to be memoryless, either probabilistic or deterministic, and the deterministic value, where you do not want to use probabilities. Be careful that the intersection of those three zones, which is here, deterministic and memoryless, so these kind of strategies are not enough to play optimally in weighted time games. This we know from a previous study, and we'll present that in a minute. But first, let me give you the contribution that we present in this paper, which is to say that the three values are the same. So probabilities can emulate memory and vice versa. And I will let Julie Parot present you first why deterministic memoryless strategies are not enough, and then give you a hint on the proof of this theorem.
Thank you, Benjamin. Before to present you the proof of the theorem, I'm going to explain why playing deterministically is not the same to play without memory. So, recall that the deterministic value is defined with this formula, where the P of SP is applied on the unique play conform to the deterministic strategies sigma and tau. Before to present you the optimal strategies for mean, I'm going to start by the computation of this value. So, on all target vertices, the deterministic value is always zero. Next, for the vertex of mean, if mean choose to go to the target, it obtains the value zero. But if mean choose to take one time this negative circle, it guarantees minus one. So if mean choose to take two times this cycle, it can guarantee the value minus two. And it can continue until it choose to take 10 times this negative cycle to obtain the value minus 10. In this case, Max has two choices: go to the target and obtain the value minus 10, or go to sigma 1, but in this case, he will obtain the value minus 11, because in sigma 1, mean can guarantee the value minus 10. So the value on C0 for Max is minus 10, 2. An optimal strategy is a strategy where its value is the supremum on the max strategies is less or equal to divide. In other words, an optimal strategy is a strategy that guarantees the value of mean. In this game, the optimal strategies of mean have as memory. In fact, if we consider the memoryless strategy to stay in the negative cycle, its value is plus infinite because the best response for Max is to stay in the negative cycle too. And in this case, the play cannot reach the target. In the case where mean chose to go to the target, he obtained the value zero. However, these optimal strategies can be a particular strategy called a switching strategy. A switching strategy is a combination with memory of two memoryless strategies. The first one, sigma one, to reach negative circle if exists. The second one, sigma 2, reach the target with an attractor strategy. So a switching strategy follows sigma 1 during the K first state and after follow sigma 2. Note that inviting time games may not have an optimal strategy, so we call our epsilon optimal strategy. Let's present you your contribution. To make the proof, we consider the set of strategies to define each value, and we show the equality by three inequalities. The first one, val is less or equal to mval, is proved to take a memoryless strategy, and by the remark that the memoryless strategy is also general strategies by inclusion of set of strategies. The second one, memoryless mval less or equal to G val is shown by take an epsilon optimal strategies that be switching strategies, and we build a memoryless strategy rho p where we use randomization to emulate memory. The last inequality, G val less or equal to val, we chose general strategies and we build a switching strategies to emulate randomization for the first strategies. In the rest of this talk, I will focus on this inequality and we present you the two arguments. So, or from a switching strategy, we use randomization to emulate memory, and the existence of an epsilon optimal switching strategies. Let's focus on the randomization used to emulate memory. So we would build rho p, a memoryless strategy, such that the limit of its value is less or equal to d val when p turns to 1 and p this time to 1. So let's consider an epsilon optimal switching strategy is in this game. So we will rho p as a probabilistic combination for two memoryless strategies of the switching strategies. In other words, in each term in sigma 1, mean can choose sigma 1 with probability p and sigma 2 with probability 1 minus p. The strategy rho p have some good properties. In fact, for all strategies of max, the probability to reach the target is equal to 1. And the expectation of the payoff is finite. Note that in finite games, the probability properties imply the expectation properties. But in infinite game, like waiting time games, this implication does not hold. We must prove the second property. The last fact is that the max has an epsilon best response deterministic strategy too. So against rho p, max can be played with a deterministic strategy. Before to show you how we prove this claim, I'm first compute the value for rho p in sigma 1 in this game. So we consider the two deterministic memoryless strategies for max. The first one to go to the target, so the expectation is equal to minus p plus minus 1 minus p times 0, so minus time p. The second one is the strategy to stay in the circle. So in this case, the expectation is given by the expected number of the cycle makes by a play. Note that in this case, that if p equal to 1, we obtain the memoryless strategy represented in orange in this game, and the value of the strategy of these strategies is plus infinity. To obtain the value of the strategy, we take the two functions and we take the max of them. So we can see we obtain the memory, the deterministic value minus 10 when p turned to 1, but p distinct to 1. To prove this claim, we will fix the best response of max and we show that the expectation of rho p and best response of max turn to d val when p turns to 1. Now I will prove this limit by computation of the expectation. The important fact of this proof is that so we can write this expectation as a discrete sum over the plane. From this sum, we split it in three subsums defined by a partition of plane reaching the target. This partition is defined in function of the length of this plane and the number of tries given by sigma 2. The first part is the yellow zone, defined where all plays are conformed to sigma 1. By definition of sigma 1, the weight of this play are less or equal to divide. Then we define the blue zone, where is a zone where all plays have many negative cycles. By definition of the parameter k, we can have that the weight of all play is less or equal to divide. Then we have the red zone, the rest of the play. In this zone, we can rewrite the sum as a sum of a product of two functions, an affine function given by the weight of the play and an exponential function given by the probabilities of the play. Moreover, we can see that the sum tends to zero when p tends to one. For the zone yellow and blue, we can rewrite the sum of subsum less or equal to divide times the probability of the two zones. We can rewrite this probability as 1 minus probabilities of red zone, and by the previous remark in red zone, we have that the sum of yellow and blue zone tends to divide when p tends to 1. By summing the two limits, we obtain the claim. So we have present, or we can use randomization to emulate memory from a switching strategy. Now we need to prove that there exists an epsilon optimal switching strategy to conclude the proof. Recall we would a switching strategy, so a combination of two memoryless strategies. So in memoryless strategies, the sequence of delays can not be turned to zero. So we restrict this proof of an existence in divergent waiting time game, where all SSA contain only negative or positive cycles, like in this figure. And in this setting, we have shown that mean has an epsilon optimal switching strategy like that, where we remark that the delays depends only of epsilon and k. To conclude, we have defined different classes of strategies and their value. In particular, we have defined VAI with a definition of probabilistic measure and expectation. And to answer the existence of these two objects, we have defined safety conditions and strategies. Moreover, in the divergent waiting time game, we have proved that mean has the same hope if he use memory or randomization. So we have used randomization to emulate memory, but we have only emulated structural memory of strategy. In fact, your strategy can use infinite precision and clock value. The next work can be define a new class of strategies with robust strategies where the infinite precision and clock is not allowed. For example, with strategies that use only continuous distribution for delay. And from this strategy, define a new value to be compare with others. Thank you for your attention.